the central power to make a difference, because she can start off with herself, or he can start off with himself. Because the most important thing is to say, what's in it for me about gossiping? Am I going to gossip? Am I going to, you know, when I see a problem coming my way, am I going to deal with it indirectly? So it's really important for the director to say, ask the honest question, do I feel like gossip can end? Or is it we're going to be all, like death and taxes? My mother used to say, we're always going to have death and taxes. Are we always going to have gossip? I don't think so, because I think that the director can do a number of things. And it's also interesting to me in terms of neuroscience that we are wired to magnify a director's influence more than we're wired to listen to someone else's, to a peer's influence. So if the director takes a stand, we're all going to feel that. So if the director comes in and says, you know what, today's the first day of the rest of our lives. By the way, that was said in the 3rd century BC, can you believe it? So it must still be true. So today's the first day of the rest of our lives. And she calls the staff and she says, look, let's talk about gossip. People looking at each other like, what is she doing? We're not supposed to talk about it. This is what we do. Let's talk about gossip. I'd like you guys to get into small groups in a minute and talk about what you think gossip is and what it's doing to the organization. So basically, she is bringing to the level of consciousness something that's always been there, but people won't talk about. And she says, look, I've read studies that 68%, true story, 68% of early childhood professionals experience gossip, negativity, backbiting, backstabbing, and whining daily. Now let's talk first in small groups about how does that affect children? How does it affect children if they see people gossiping and being negative? What happens? So then you invite the teachers to talk in small groups about what happens with children when they watch adults. And before you know it, the staff are saying, well, the children, I just saw little Jane. Little Jane said, I'm not going to play with Madison for 100 years, are you? So obviously children are learning from us.
Must be excited.
Oh, wait, hold that story. I just remembered this. Did you hear the rumor about Janet?
So what can I do if I'm trying to maintain a gossip-free work environment and the gossiper comes up to me? There's a lot that I can do. Let's step aside first, though, and say it's about power. If I'm the director, I have the power to hire and fire. So I can take the gossiper through progressive discipline. But if I'm just another teacher, she comes up to me, I know if she gossips to me, she will gossip about me. So what I know is, if I confront her directly, by the way, confrontation doesn't mean to smack somebody. It means to bring people face to face to work out the difficulties. That's what the Latin root is. So if the gossiper comes up to me, I have all kinds of things I can say. I can say, you know what? Wow, it sounds like you've really got an issue with the director. Let's go together right now and talk with her. Now you know the gossiper's not going to want to do that, so she's going to walk away. She might come back later. She's going to be gossiping to me again. I'm going to try something different. I'm going to say, look, since you don't want to go to the director and talk with her about it, how about we sit here, problem solve, and I can coach you, maybe share some things you could go with. Back to the director. She doesn't want to do that either. Or I could say stuff like, I'm focusing on the children, or, you know, we sign an agreement not to gossip, or, you know, right up there on the wall is our mission statement, and it says RESPECT. You know, and that, I just don't feel comfortable talking about someone who's not present. So I have all kinds of things I can do without pushing back and confronting the gossiper directly if I'm afraid that she's going to get on my case next. But you know what? Some of us are willing to say, what you just said is inappropriate, and I don't want to hear it.
Did you see who was late again?
You mean Rosie?
Yeah.
That's like the 10th time this week.
I know, and you know, if it was anybody else, that we'd be written up.
It takes courage to realize that for creativity to happen, I need to address what's going on around me. I want to give you one other example of what happens. Another thing besides gossip that pulls a program down is whining. And I'm sure that everyone has dealt with someone who comes in and says, I'm so tired. I am so tired. Oh my goodness, I hope I don't have to do another thing today. Oh, the classroom portfolio, I can't do it. Now guess what? A whiner brings people down just like a gossiper does, because we all have mirror neurons. It's an interesting thing. We all have mirror neurons, which means that if we're in proximity to each other, we start soaking up each other's feelings. So if someone's coming around and whining, it's going to bring me down too. So what there are things to do. This is very simple with whiners, do's and don'ts. Don't agree with the whiner. It's like agreeing with a gossiper. She's going to keep whining. Don't disagree with her, because she's going to have to prove she's right. And don't fix it for her, because you give a person a fish, she eats for a day. So she'll keep coming back to you with all of her problems. What you should do is what many of us are taught not to do. Interrupt the whiner and say, could you give me a concrete example of what you're talking about? She's not going to want to do that, because the whole purpose is to whine. So she'll go away. She'll be back. So when she comes back, she has a concrete example. You say, well, let's sit down with each other and see if we can work together to solve that problem. Is she going to want to solve the problem? Nope, because she wants to whine. So I say, can't help you with that problem, sorry. When she comes back, here is the magic phrase, works like a charm. She comes back and she's ready to whine to me. I say, stop, excuse me. Please don't bring that problem to me again. Since I can't help you with that problem, please don't bring it to me again. And I have had whiners come up to me and have to stop 5 feet away from me because they know what I'm going to say. Since I can't help you with that problem, please don't bring it to me again.